We're glad to be in the Lord's house tonight. Praise God.
Amen.
And we're looking forward to what He's going to do here. And we have a message coming up here in just a minute from Brother Bob McKinney. And we don't forget the Lord's benefits, because He has good benefits for us. Right now we're approaching Christmas, and we're going to sing this song. That first Christmas, can you imagine that night when the Lord came down? He wants to bless us that same way tonight.
Certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they lay, leaving their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep.
Thank you, Lord, for coming. He is worthy of the praise. We look around nature. We look at all that He's done, and He is worthy of all the blessing that we can give. is none like him. None like him that could come and change us. Lord, we just worship you tonight. Could you give him praise? As he's setting that back up, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We just love you tonight. We just want to say how majestic and awesome you are. And we sing for joy for it tonight. In the middle of the week, dear God, we give you praise. Whatever's going on, dear God, we give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name. Jesus, there's none like you.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days, I want to praise the wonders of
to the promise I have.
nothing compares to him. And if he has come, the only response we can say is, we shout to you, Lord, and we give you praise. We rejoice in you, Lord, tonight. Hallelujah. Can you just praise him one more time in the house? You are worthy. You are worthy, dear God, for coming to us. The people that didn't deserve it, but you came anyway. You loved us that night. We worship you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Isn't he good, church? He is a good God. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you all so much. And praise his name tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Brother Bob will be back in just a second here. Thank you, Brother Greg. Mr. Gabe. We're glad you tuned in tonight with us out there. And Brother Dave and Sister Jamie, if you're watching, we just prayed for you and continue to pray for you. And others out there, we know we have our regular folks that watch us out there. We're so glad you're with us. Looking forward to something special here in just a minute. Just a little bit about what's going on for us. If you're out there watching, appreciate all your prayers for us. We'll have as much of this as we can on the internet. But we do have our nursing home sign up for those here. And we did take up for actually two patients and an extra patient, so I hear. So we're glad we could get for three patients, and I'm looking forward to blessing with it on the 18th. So there's still time if you want to bring something. They can always use body wash and those type things, or lotion, if someone wants to just bring some of that. So but that is coming up this Sunday is the deadline, and we'll be taking it to them Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock. We'll be taking them the materials and singing carols to them at 3 on December the 18th. And we also will be having Santa Claus come to help us do that.
So, oh, Santa Claus.
Mm-hmm. Santa Claus is coming to Auburn. So we're looking forward to it. And also on Sunday morning coming up, we do have our kids play. So I know Miss Mika and Miss Nita and Miss Kay have been working. So we appreciate that. Looking forward to that coming up here. And we do have the 25th as Sunday, too, and so we'll have a special service that day. And then the last two Sunday evenings of the month, we will not have service at 6 o'clock. So just keep that in mind. No service here at 6 until New Year's. We will be back on New Year's Day with service then. So a lot of good things we'll look forward to, and just keep tuned, keep praying. It's a tough season, we know, sometimes out there, but just keep believing for good. And I'm thankful for a brother here that is praying and believing for many, and his brother Bob McKinney, and he's got a word. By the way, if you're out there on Facebook or the internet, I believe it's Gospel Partners. Is that the name?
Gospel Partners in Jesus.
Gospel Partners in Jesus. Look up Brother Bob. He's got some words he shared on there and some other awesome folks as well. But we appreciate Brother Bob and the blessing he is. And he's got a word tonight. God bless you, brother.
Gospel Partners in Jesus is that ministry I started way back in about 2002. And God has done some awesome, awesome things with it. And I came to a time that I thought it was proper to pick it back up again. You know, the Lord is just so great. And I want to say something before I get started. I don't preach to get on the better side of people. I don't preach to impress people. But I do my best to give you the truth. And I said that to say this. Sunday morning, you heard a message full of truth. And I thought it was an awesome message. The reason that some people water down the word is because they love themselves more than they love God. They love themselves more than they love you. And you can be grateful that you're in a church, that you got a pastor that doesn't water it down, that preaches the truth. And that is all important, because that's what gives you what you need in life to be an overcomer. An overcomer. And you know, I know you can say both Nathan and I are seeking to give you the complete truth that lifts you up to a higher plane, that helps you get victory, that helps you to ride out every storm and defeat every storm. That helps you to flatten every mountain. God is so able.
He is.
He is so able and he's so good. And we're living in a day, I tell you what, people, we're getting close to the rapture.
That's right.
Things that are taking place, are just, this prophecy is being fulfilled rapidly every day.
Yes, it is.
Things in Iran, they're coming in line. You know, things in Turkey, they're coming in line. And the different nations that are around Israel are coming in line. And there are three red helpers that are going to be slaughtered around in September. And it will give the Jews the ashes that they need to start the temple. And they haven't prepared. They could probably build that temple in 2 or 3 days because they got every block already built. And there's a group of people that are digging out the things that were taken out of the temple. And there is a man in Israel that the Jews say is a Messiah that has come working miracles. Earlier this week, he worked his 6th miracle. His first miracles weren't too powerful. But now he's out healing people that are critical. And so, and everything's coming together. Around the end of 2023, it looks like things are just coming together, coming together. You know what that tells me? That the rapture could be any second now.
That's right.
It could be any second. It could be before we ever get out the door tonight. So it pays to be ready.
That's right.
And the church needs the truth preached to them. You know, we need a good, strong message that puts some meat on our bones. You know, we need that to prepare and be strong enough and ready for the Lord's coming. And you know, I believe that it's not only happening here, but I believe that it's happening all over the world. That's God's anointing. That's God's great spirit. Praise God. Glory to God. And I feel the Lord. I feel the Lord tonight. God is good. He is here with us.
That's right.
You know? I wouldn't get up here if I didn't feel the Lord. If Nathan called me up here and I couldn't feel the Lord, I'd say, I'm not prepared. You know? God is good.
Yes.
God is awesome. Are you ready to see Jesus Christ?
Come, Lord.
You know, it may be today, tomorrow, morning, noon, or night. It may come sooner than we could ever think. Praise the Lord. Psalms 103 and 1 says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is written within me, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
That's right.
Forget not all his benefits. You know, to understand and receive the benefits, you have to have received the truth. You have to understand the truth. And you know, there's some things that haven't been preached strong enough. Because we don't necessarily have the faith and the power to make all things happen yet. But they have to be preached first. And you know what, Nathan? We're on our way. We are on our way. And it will be done by the glory of the Lord. Not by might, not by spirit, flesh, but by his spirit, says the Lord. You know, his spirit will do it. He will work it within us. Forget not all our benefits. And you know, the benefits are great. It's not only the benefits of salvation and healing, and the working of miracles. But it's a benefit of the truth. Truth is a great benefit. It lays a line down that we can walk by. It gives us instructions and teaches us to live right. It takes us to the cross and teaches us sanctification and gives us the power to possess ourselves in sanctification and honor. It does. The truth is all important. Jesus Christ Himself is the truth. He is the truth. Glory to God. Glory to God. And forgives all my iniquities and heals all my diseases. Who redeems your life from destruction. Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercy. Oh, what great benefits. Who satisfies your mouth with good things, so that your youth is renewed like an eagle. Is that a mistake? Dwight, is that a mistake? Between him and I, we're the two oldest people in here. He told me the other night that he wasn't as old as me. And I said, what, you're not 85 yet? But you know, is that a mistake in the word? So that that your youth is renewed like an eagle. That's one of the benefits.
Right.
We'll give you, you know, it's not going to make my face look young. This graying in my hair and these wrinkles and age spots that I got, it's not going to take it away. But in my spirit,
yes.
In my spirit, I can be renewed like an eagle.
Oh, yes. Yes.
You know? Sometimes you ought to be in my house through the day. I get happy. I can get to dancing in my house because I feel the presence of the Lord, because He's renewing me. He's renewing me. He's making me whole again. Yes. You know? And it makes me feel like every day, oh, I'm ready to see Jesus. I am so ready to see Jesus.
Nay.
Praise God. Praise God. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all who are oppressed. We have an enemy that would oppress us, that would keep us down. He's cunning. He's going about like a roaring lion.
Right.
He's taking out everyone that he can. And he's doing all the harm to each and every one of us that he can. But the Lord in His truth will renew our spirits.
Amen.
Renew so that your youth is renewed like an eagle. Sometimes some things in the Bible just sounds too good to be true. You wonder if it's a mistake, but it's truth. There's no mistakes in the Word of God. You want to change the way you feel about things? You want to change the things that pull you down and oppress you? Get in the Word of God. Get in the Word of God and take a hold of this truth. And say it's true.
That's right.
Oh, praise God. There was a lady, and I believe she was a dear friend of my departed wife, Sister Magruder. She could sing. She could sing and stir. And when she would sing, she would get to going in the audience and laying hands on people. And sometimes people would be healed. She got cancer. And she fought it. And she tried so hard to beat it. And one night in the middle of the night, her husband missed her in the bed. And he found her out in the living room her Bible on the floor, and she's standing on the Bible. He said, "What are you doing?" She said, "I'm standing on a word. I'm standing on a word. It's mine. I'm standing on it." And you know what? The Lord healed her. The Lord healed her. Praise God. Sometimes you just got to take hold of faith. And sometimes you have to say, "Devil, you're just not going to defeat me. You're not going to defeat me because this word says different. This word says different. And am I going to believe what the devil says? Or am I going to believe what men are teaching? Or am I going to believe the word?" The word that holy men of God brings to you. Praise God. Believe the word. Accept his benefits. Hang on to them.
Yes.
And you'll become more than a conqueror. More than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. You can become a powerhouse through faith in the word. Through believing the word. You read something and it sounds too good to be true. Don't question it. Don't ponder it. Say, "It says it in the word, and I'm going to take it. And I'm going to continue on and live in faith until I can receive what it says. Until I can receive the great benefits in this book." I believe that we're coming to a day where there'll be no sickness in the house of God. I believe it. Because that's what I understand by reading the Word of God. That we're going to come together as a corporate body. As a corporate body. Faith one to another. Lifting one another up. Believing. Believing. And it's not something that we can do. But it's something that God is going to do.
Right.
God is going to do. Amen. Praise God. He's going to bring us to that church, a perfect church, without spot or wrinkle or blemish. He's going to bring us to that place.
Yes.
And I'll tell you what, when we get there, he's not going to give us a chance to lose out because the rapture is going to take place. When we get there, the rapture will be caught up. Praise God. Can you imagine? A worldwide church. All coming to the same place at the same time. Only God can do that. Only God can do that. His power is far more awesome than we can believe. His power is far more awesome than we can understand. Only God can do these things.
Right.
So church, I ask you to step out. Take hold of the word and say, "I'm going to believe God. And I'm going to take hold of every benefit that's in this book. I'm going to believe it. I'm going to believe it. And if I have to take this book and pound Satan over the head with it, that's what I'll do. That's what I'll do." And I'm going to tell you this. Satan is not so powerful as you might think. He only has the power that we allow him to have.
Right.
Those that disbelieve.
That's it.
He is trembling. He is fearful. And he knows his time is short. And he's fighting with everything that he's that's within him. Psalms 18. And I didn't put it in there. You don't have to worry about it. Psalms 18 and 30 says, "For as God, his way is perfect. The words of the Lord is tried. He is my buckler and all those that trust in him. For who is God save the Lord? or who is the rock save our God? Who is the rock save our God? He is the rock of my salvation. He is that rock that will never be shaken, that never will tremble. And you know, I've got my foot on a rock. Right. I've got my foot on a rock. And held in praise. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. I am on my way to glory. I'm on my way to glory. I found that path. I found that perfect path that God lights before me. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. And it lights my way. I found that path and with joy. With joy. I'm walking down the path. Praise God. Yes. Glory to God.
That's right.
He's like a shotgun on my tie. Glory to God. My God is real. My God is real. It is God that girdeth me with strength and maketh my ways perfect. I have no strength of my own. I cannot stand up against this world. I cannot stand up against the enemy of my soul. But it's God that gives me the strength.
Right.
It's God that gives me the strength. And His word is powerful enough in me that makes me an overcomer. It makes me an overcomer. Glory to God. Glory to God. He maketh my feet like hinds' feet and setteth me upon a high place. Have you ever seen maybe on TV or something? Two mountain goats, they hit each other head on. And the noise rings throughout the mountains. But neither one of them go down because they got a pair of hinds feet that gives them strength. That gives them strength that they can hit with a mighty force. A mighty force. And you know, God makes our feet like we have those hinds feet. That we can't be knocked off of our feet. That we have the power to stand. Praise God. He teaches my hand to war so that the bow of steel is broken in my arm. Thou hast also given me the shield of salvation, and thy right hand has holden me up. And thy gentleness has made me great. Has made me great. David here was saying, the Spirit of the Lord has made me great. Has made me great. Has made me great. Because whether we realize it or not, we are caught up in the midst of a war between good and evil.
Yes.
Between good and evil.
That's right.
And I've got news for you. My God will not be defeated. Amen. My God will not be defeated. God cannot be defeated. Praise God. He makes us more than a conqueror. He makes us more than an overcomer. You and I stand through the word and the power of God. Amen. As soldiers of the cross.
Yes.
As soldiers of the cross. As mighty warriors. As mighty warriors. And it's not my might. It's not my strength. But it is the Spirit of the Lord that holds us up. Mm-hmm. Praise God. Thou hast enlarged my steps under me, that my feet did not slip. I have pursued my enemy and overtaken them. Neither did I turn again till they were consumed. I have wounded them that they may that they were not able to rise. They have fallen under my feet. For thou hast girded me with strength into the battle, and hast subdued under me those that rose up against me. What's that saying? He has given us strength to overcome the enemy. And you know, sometimes we need to not just sit back and let the devil do what he wants to do. Sometimes we need to pursue him. Sometimes we need to pursue him. Like Nancy Sinatra used to sing, these boots are made for walking. These boots are made for walking. Some of you may remember that. These boots are made for walking. And devil, I'm going to walk all over you. Devil, I'm going to walk all over you. And you can understand the way that I preach, why the devil comes after me at times. And sometimes he gets a little brave. But you know, I had to show him I'm not dead. I'm not weakened anymore. But I have the Word of God hidden in my heart. I have the strength of the Lord in my heart. And shut up in my bones, I feel the fire of the Holy Ghost. I said, shut up in my bones, I can feel the fire of the Holy Ghost. He said, I'll baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. I can't help the way that I act. I can't help the way that I teach and I preach. Because I feel that fire shut up inside of me. It's real. It's real. And I'm alive in Jesus Christ.
Right.
Are you alive tonight?
Yes.
Praise Him. Worship Him. Are you alive tonight?
Thank
Glory
you.
To God. Glory to God.
Thank you.
Let's be lively stones.
Yes.
Let's be lively stones. Let's don't be weak. Let's don't give the enemy an inch. When he comes around, just give him a good look. Give him a good look. Like, you have no place here. You have no place here. And if he doesn't flee, pursue him. And with those boots that are made for walking, just walk all over him. Walk all over him. You can't just instantly get that kind of strength. You can't just instantly get that kind of faith. But it's something that you got to work at. You got to read the Word. You got to trust in the Word. And maybe you have to be like the man. I've said it many times. Lord, help my unbelief. Something else that I've been known to say down through the years. Lord, if you don't help me, I'm not going to make it this time. I've been in many situations where I said to the Lord, Lord, if you don't help me, I'm not going to make it. Because I knew I didn't have the power and the strength in myself. But His Word declares that I can make it. His Word gives me strength. Faith in God gives you strength. The Word says, the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. And I'll tell you what, I believe this. The greatest thing that we can know, and we might not have to understand a lot, but we need to know that Calvary is real. Calvary is real. And the power and the strength and the help and the joy and peace that we get all come from Calvary. The work of the cross.
Right.
The work of the cross. Jesus did it all. Jesus did it all. Praise God. Glory to God.
Amen.
And when we have trouble, we need to look to the cross. Sometimes maybe we need to go back to the cross and kneel at the cross and find our strength and our hope, because it is all in Jesus Christ through the work of the cross. Through the work of the cross. Praise God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Aren't you so grateful that He chose to leave heaven? That He left heaven one day, and can't you just see Him stepping on Jupiter and Mars and coming down to earth and wrapping Himself in the womb of a woman and being born as a babe and rose and fought for us and won the battle when they nailed Him on the cross. They nailed Him on the cross. That was His victory. He gave Himself. Through all the pain and agony, He stayed on the cross. And He died for you and I. But that was just a battle. And in 3 days, He rose again. 3 days, He rose again. And he came to live in me. He came to live in you. You know? And He said, John the Baptist baptizes you in water, but I came to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. My God is a consuming fire. I want all that I can get of God. I want all that I can get of God. And the closer I get to the end of my life, I personally believe that I'm going to see the rapture. But if I don't, I know my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. You know, and I'm assured. And you know, on the way to church tonight and this afternoon, I felt an assurance deep down in me. Did you ever pray and you feel like it's just not there yet? And you pray some more and it's just not there yet. And you pray some more and it's just not there. And then all of a sudden comes an assurance. An assurance. And you feel the Spirit of God inside of you. And you feel that assurance. I feel an assurance that God is going to do something in my life. I feel assurance that God is going to transform my life. I feel an assurance that the Lord is leading me. And I'm not totally sure where He's leading me. But we used to sing a song when I was a kid. Where you lead me, I will follow. I will follow. I will follow Him wherever He leads me. Oh, yes. Isn't Jesus Christ wonderful?
Yes.
Isn't Jesus Christ awesome? Yes. The Lord is good. And you know, I love Jesus Christ. I love the Father. I love the sweet Spirit of God. And being greedy, I want all that I can get. I want to be possessed by the Spirit. So much so that He controls my life. That He controls my life. And gives me what He wants me to have. And He makes me what He wants me to be. I don't have to plan it out. I don't have to plan it out. You know? Because God, it's all in the hand of God. And His precious, precious love. Heavenly Father, Lord, we need You. We need You. If there's any need under the sound of my voice, Lord, lay Your hand upon it. Lord, if there's any need under the sound of my voice, just speak the word. Just speak the word, Lord. We love you. We love you and we praise you, God. And I pray that you meet every need. I claim that you meet every need. Where it's healing, or we need to be lifted out of oppression, that we need to be lifted up to a higher plane, Lord. Whatever the need, Lord. You said, forget not all my benefits. Lord, your benefits are so great and beyond anything that we can ever imagine. And Lord, help us to walk, lay hold to the truth and to your spirit and be possessed of you, God. And I pray in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ, that whatever the need is, where it's healing, whether it's financial or it's personal, someone needs a deliverance, God, I claim it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
What is this? Wish I could be in church.
Thank you, Jesus. And Lord, I agree with Brother Bob. I just want to say, the same victory that I know you're bringing in him, the same assurances he's talked about tonight, dear Lord, as he's prayed for others out there and others here in this place tonight, I agree with that they'll get that, that they will receive as well all the benefits that you have, lacking nothing, dear Lord.
Amen.
We will be perfected, dear God, as your word says, as it gets closer to the day you come back, that you will work in us, dear God, good things. And we love you for it. We believe for each one in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We appreciate Brother Bob and him sharing the word tonight. But that word resonated in you. We have benefits in the battle we're in right now. It's not neglected. We love you. We'll see you real soon in Christian life. And God bless you richly.